Letty considered these strange ideas. "I never thought of him like that," she said at last. "It makes it all seem different." "Nor did I, but I do now. I have suddenly found it and seen it plain. I see it so plain that I am amazed that I have not always seen it. It is, you see, so easy to understand that there is a God, and how complex and wonderful and brotherly he is, when one thinks of those dear boys who by the thousand, by the hundred thousand, have laid down their lives. Aye, and there were German boys, too, who did the same. The cruelties, the injustice, the brute aggression, they saw it differently. They laid down their lives. They laid down their lives. Those dear lives, those lives of hope and sunshine. Don't you see that it must be like that, Letty? Don't you see that it must be like that?" "No," she said, "I've seen things differently from that." "But it's so plain to me," said Mr. Britling. "If there was nothing else in all the world but our kindness for each other, or the love that made you weep in this kind October sunshine, or the love I bear Hugh, if there was nothing else at all, if everything else was cruelty and mockery and filthiness and bitterness, it would still be certain that there was a God of love and righteousness. If there were no signs of God in all the world but the godliness we have seen in those two boys of ours, if we had no other light but the love we have between us." "You don't mind if I talk like this?" said Mr. Britling. "It's all I can think of now. This God who struggles, who is in Hugh and Teddy, clear and plain, and how he must become the ruler of the world.